What's up, guys? Greg with Pizzle's Tech Time, back again with another video. And today, we're looking at a product that was sent to me for review by a company named CamiSafe. This product, it's a combination of a selfie stick and a tripod in one, and it also has a Bluetooth remote. So I thought it would be pretty cool to take a look at, as sometimes I'm at the casino trying to record slot play, or I'm recording these tech videos somewhere out and about, and I thought a selfie stick would be helpful. This has been like my go-to kind of selfie stick, and I even bought the cell phone mount for the Joby GorillaPod. The problem with this is for anything other than a cell phone, I don't know how you would use it because it is far too flimsy. Now, it does work with the DSLR, but I would not trust it out and about. I see people strapping this to trees and hanging their camera off of it, and I just don't trust these that much. It's a solid metal construction for the most part, except for the brackets here, which are metal and plastic. But my main issue that I have with this thing is how thin it is, and it's a little rackety. So in order to grip the rubber, you have to open it like a tripod. So what I found was using it like this closed is better for the sound if you're recording video, because once you grip this, it is no longer going to be making that sound, but I still find that pretty annoying. And even with it closed, this thing can still move. So if you are not holding it from the bottom right here, you're gonna get that sound right there. Other than that, I gotta say this thing is pretty sturdy. You just open it up like a tripod, put it down, and it works fine. I think it serves its purpose pretty well, and I can just show you about how far this thing opens up. It's about, I'd say it's about 4 feet. Pretty good length for when you're holding it out here. You get some awesome shots with that, and I think that's pretty amazing. And it has three locking rings right here to stop it from collapsing on itself. And overall, it works really well. We've got rubber feet around it, and we've got some rubber right here. Now, you can use it like this and stick your hand here, but these have to be open. I don't hate the design, but in order to grip the rubber, these have to be open, which can restrict your movement. And overall, it's just a little bit annoying. In my honest opinion, guys, I think it's a pretty cool product, and for the price that they're selling it at, it's pretty decent. If I was going to use a selfie stick a lot, I would just buy a selfie stick on its own, but I really don't use it that much, and sometimes you need to place your camera down. My third and final comment about this product is I think that the phone holder that it ships with, it's just not up to par, guys. I mean, unfortunately, it's not gonna fit your bigger phones, especially if you have a case on it. I have a Galaxy S9 Plus, and this thing is not fitting it at all. Once you get a little phone in here, it does hold it pretty well. The design of this is not the best. It has a little 1/4-20 mount right there that you can use, a 1/4-inch mount. It's pretty normal for small tripods to use that mount, so it's compatible with just about anything. This Joby phone holder was almost $50 in itself. That's more expensive than the tripod itself, but it does serve its purpose. And I can put this on the GorillaPod, or I can use it here with the selfie stick. Now, I think for the price of this selfie stick, it needs to have a better phone holder. I mean, that's the purpose of this thing, to hold your phone. And just a simple design like this, where it unlocks and locks with a screw, that way you don't have these issues. And I think when using a selfie stick and moving about, you're gonna want your device to be secure when you're using it on this thing. If you have a newer phone, I can't really suggest using this, because if you use the phone holder that comes with it, I don't know, guys. I just really think this design is far too simple. And if your phone fits in here, you have a smaller phone and you like the design, that's all good and well. I'll have a link for it in the description below. CamiSafe or Yongtang, whoever the company is that wanted me to review this product, they obviously want a video for their product and they want a good review. But the problem is the design is not my favorite. I do like the fact that you can use it as a tripod and a selfie stick. I find it pretty useful. But if I did have this thing all the way extended, would I really put an expensive camera on here? Probably not, guys, because It's not the most sturdy thing in the world, but if you want to just put something down for a second, that's fine. But if the wind blows and you got something heavy on there, it's going to topple over. The feet are just not wide enough. It's pretty nifty to use. It's a nifty little product. So here's the price on Amazon, $25.99, and you can use a 6% coupon. For that price, it's not a bad purchase, but in no means is this thing perfect. Will it help you and enable you to create some cool videos with the selfie stick and nice photos? I think so, yes. But for $30 or close to $30, they need to have a better mount than this for your device. And that's just my honest opinion, guys. Just because this thing was sent to me does not mean I'm going to recommend it to you guys. If you watch this video and you think you could use this, there'll be a link for it in the description below. In no means would I be 100% satisfied with my purchase. I do believe this phone holder takes it down quite a few notches just from the design. And trying to fit my phone in holders like this, I've actually broke them before. So it's not abnormal for selfie sticks to come with bad phone holders. But I think if this company wants to stand above the rest, they will design a better phone holder. Sort of like the Joby phone holder that I have on there. And that's just my honest opinion. But other than that, guys, the Bluetooth remote is super easy to set up and it comes off as well if you would like to set it up and use it in the tripod mode. And you can just click this button. And you do have to change the settings on your phone to make the volume key zoom, which I don't like because I usually hit the volume key to take a picture when I'm doing a selfie. And when using this correctly, you cannot do that, but it does connect super easily. All you have to do is connect it as a Bluetooth device and you're good to go. And it does work with iOS and Android, so there's a thumbs up for that. Super easy setup. I do enjoy using that portion of it. And it fits right back in that rubber grip right there. Do I worry about this falling out? I think it's pretty sturdy and I'm pretty happy with that design there. So my main gripe with this thing is, does it serve its function? Using it like this, it's a little noisy for video and it's kind of tough to get a good grip on it without your knuckle hitting this, making noise. So for video, it's not my favorite selfie stick at all. And for photos, I think it works perfect. So this is gonna be used more for photos for me. And I like the fact that I can set it up on the floor and have it just record me. So I think this company has a great idea, a 2-in-1 selfie stick / tripod. And I think it works pretty well. I give it about 3.5 stars out of 5. And I think they're pretty close, but not quite there yet. If they can design a better phone holder and a little bit better of a grip, I think if the grip extended longer here so you could still hold it and the legs kind of came down a little bit, like right to here, and the legs were a little longer and more sturdier, this thing would be perfect. Don't get me wrong, guys, nothing's perfect, and I'm not saying this is a bad product, I'm just saying that's my review of it. It's 3.5 out of 5 stars, and I think it needs some design improvements in order for it to be better recommended by me. If you did find this video helpful, make sure you hit that subscribe button, followed by the notification bell, so you'll be notified next time I drop a video. I do these videos weekly in 4K 60 frames per second, and I greatly appreciate you subscribing and following the channel, guys. And if you are interested in purchasing the product, like I said earlier, links in the description for everything, all my gear included. So I want to thank you guys for watching. I'll see you next week. Greg with Pizzle's Tech Time, I'm out.